स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज योर कंप्यूटर टीचर इफ्तिखार अहमद, ग्रेड 6. हियर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द टॉपिक व्हिच सेज द जनरेशन ऑफ कंप्यूटर्स. द क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट इज अ जनरेशन. हियर वी आर सपोज्ड टू स्टार्ट एंड एक्सप्लेन व्हाट इज अ जनरेशन ऑफ कंप्यूटर्स. क्वेश्चन नंबर सेज डिफाइन जनरेशन एंड एक्सप्लेन देम. The answer is there are five generations of the computer. So according to five generations, we will start one by one. First, the first generation of computer, which started from 1940 to 1956, they have been about 16 years. The first generation was based on vacuum tubes. The example of the first generation is ENIAC. And now, quantum computer is going to talk about such a first generation. The first generation, which started from the 1940, was based on vacuum tubes. And in the story of the first generation, they meant the older generation, where the computer was bigger, was larger in size. The first generation computer ENIAC, which I just mentioned over here, was taking around two rooms. And the problem it was creating, firstly it was taking too much big size, and also what it was doing, it was creating a lot of the heat due to its size. It was taking more light, the electricity, so it is a big draw of the first generation. Now we are going to move on the second generation of the computer, which started from 1956 to 1964. Was based on the transistors. And the third generation of the computer, which is based on the ICs, that mean integrated circuits, was started from the 64 to 71. In the third generation, as I told you, the first generation was based on the vacuum tubes, the second generation was based on the transistors, and the third generation is based on the ICs, that mean the integrated circuits, where the transistor were not replaced, the transistor were added the ICs. And the third generation, the computer boosted up the speed. The third generation started from 64 and 1971. This was the period where the operating system was created, where the computer became faster because the processor was made in the year 1970. Now the computer was more faster than its predecessors. जो भी इससे पहले आते हैं उससे बहुत ही ज्यादा fast. अब हम आ रहे हैं the fourth generation of computer, which started in the year 1971 to present, which is called the microprocessor of the computers. Now the question is, did the ICs were removed? No. The ICs were available in the computer. Only the computer became the micro. Here the word micro, it means smaller in size. In the fourth generation, means 71 to present, what did the computer do? The computer became smaller in size. Now everyone can use the computer on the palm of the hand only. For example, as I just told you, the first generation of the computer was taking two rooms around. It was taking too much speed. It was taking too much space. It was also using a lot of heat. While the as the computer became the micro, the computer size became from two rooms to palm of your hand. So it became very smaller. The cell phone, the tablet, the laptop, all the example of the microprocessor. Where you might know or not, but your cell phone is also the processor. While its size is very smaller, so you can use as a micro technology. Here, the fifth generation, the last one, which is the fifth generation of the computer, starts from the present to beyond. That means something which is right now we are using, and something which is about to come, about to launch, about under the development, is called beyond. That means future, which is called the AI. Here the word AI is stands for the artificial intelligence. That means something which is not real, which does not have the intelligence, but yeah, it is called AI. That means artificial intelligence. The computer is the only thing which has developed very quickly, very fastly. So a lot of people do not know what is about to come. For example, if we are taking the example of the AI, they mean the artificial intelligence. There the robots are coming. Even if you are using your cell phone, it is either here the iOS, the Apple, or you are using the Android, the any cell phone. So in an Android, you have the Google Assistant. If you are just going to press home reset button on the cell phone, the Google Assistant will be on. You can directly talk to Google Assistant and you will have the reply. So lot of the things in background which are doing like real things now, the artificial intelligence, even robots are better. In the year 2016, the robot was developed by the countries from Dubai in the year 2016. The name of the robot is Sophia. You can simply type on Google or in a search the Sophia robot. You will have the example of the artificial intelligence. Dear students, I just request you subscribe my channel for more information. I just created the complete best video, so you can just click to subscribe to see the more videos. If you do have any question related to this topic, I will make a video. Thank you. This is the complete teacher. Thank you very much. Allah Hafiz.